हेलो फ्रेंड्स एंड स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू मशीन डिजाइन लेक्चर। टुडे वी विल डिस्कस वन न्यूमेरिकल ऑन बैल क्रैंक लीवर। सो लेट अस सी क्वेश्चन, व्हाट इज गिवन टू अस इन द क्वेश्चन। सो प्रॉब्लम इज डिजाइन अ राइट एंगल बैल क्रैंक लीवर। Horizontal arm of the lever is 500 mm and a load of 4500 Newton acts vertically downwards through a pin in the forked end of this arm. At the end of 150 mm long arm, which is perpendicular to 500 mm long arm, a force P acts at right angles to the axis of 150 mm arm through a pin into a forked end. So both ends are forked ends. Lever consists of forged steel material and a pin at the fulcrum. Take the following data for both the pins and lever material. Safe stress in tension 75 MPa. Safe shear stress 60 MPa and bearing pressure on the pin 10 Newton per mm square. So let us write given data. Length of load arm is 500 mm. W is 4500 Newton. Length of effort arm is 150 mm. Permissible tensile stress is 75 Newton per mm square. Permissible shear stress is 60 Newton per mm square. And bearing pressure is 10 Newton per mm square. So here, this is the sketch. W, L1, P, L2. And this is the section YY, where bending failure of the lever will occur. So we will follow this table for all 5 steps. Quickly we will revise. First step is calculation of P and RF. First we will apply condition of equilibrium. And then we'll put a formula of RF. Then design of pin at fulcrum considering bearing pressure failure. We will use this formula. RF is equal to 1.25 times D square into bearing pressure. L is 1.25 times D. Considering double shear failure of the pin, we will check the design of pin. We will find tau induced and compare with the tau permissible. And providing bush, we will find out the diameter of hole in the lever and diameter of boss. Third step is design of pin at effort point. So if value of P is close to RF, then same pin we will be using. Then we will be using here. Fourth step, ABC, is similar to the 2ABC. And here we will be designing the pin at the load point. Load point value is W, so we will use this equation and find D2 and then L2. Then we will check pin for double shear failure. And providing bush, we will find out the dimensions of the forked end of lever. Last step is design of lever in bending failure. So we will use equation of bending moment and section modulus and substitute that values in the bending stress equation. We can find T and B. So let us solve this sum. First, we will calculate P and RF. As I told you, taking moments about the fulcrum. So W into L1 is equal to P into L2. Substituting values, we will find value of P. Now, using parallelogram law of theory, that is principle, we will be using equation RF is equal to under root W square plus P square plus 2PW cos theta. Here theta is 90 degree. So cos 90 degree is 0. So our equation of RF is this. Let us substitute values of W and P, and we will get the value reaction at fulcrum is 15,660 Newton. Second step is design of P net fulcrum, and in A step we will consider bearing pressure failure. So bearing pressure failure, RF will be equal to projected area into bearing pressure. We have values of RF and PB, and we'll put L is equal to 1.25 times D. So we will now substitute all values and we will be able to find diameter of pin, which comes 35.4 mm. So we will take say 36 mm and length is 25% extra. So it is 45 mm. Now we will check design of pin for double shear failure. So RF is equal to 2 into pi by 4 D square into tau induced. So we will substitute all values and we will find with the induced stress. Our permissible stress is 60 Newton per mm square. As induced stress is less than permissible value, therefore design of pin is safe. Now step C is to find diameter of hole and boss for the lever. So let us provide brass bush of 3 mm thickness, which will be pressed into the boss fulcrum, so that in case of wearing, renewal becomes simple. So diameter of hole in the lever is D plus 6, which is 42 mm, and diameter of boss is 2D, so it will be 72 mm. Third step is we will check value of P with RF. P is 15,000 Newton and RF is 15,660, which is almost closer. So if diameter of P net fulcrum is 36 mm, we will get diameter of P net effort point will be approximately equal to 34 mm. So to reduce the variations, to reduce the inventory, and to avail the facility of interchangeability, we will use same dimensions of pin at effort point, which is designed for the fulcrum. So D1 will be equal to D and L1 will be equal to L. Next step is design of pin at load point. So D2, L2 are diameter and length of the pin at load point. In step A, we'll consider the bearing pressure failure. So W is equal to projected area into bearing pressure. So let us substitute the values and use L2 is equal to 1.25 times D2. So from this equation, we will find value of D2, which is 18.97, say 20 mm, and L2 is equal to 25 mm. Now we will check design of pin for double shear failure. So W is equal to 2 into pi by 4 D2 square into tau induced. Let us substitute all values of W and D2. We will be able to find tau induced. Here we get 7.16 Newton per mm square and permissible is 60 Newton per mm square. So we can see that induced stress is less than permissible. So design of pin at load point is safe for shear failure. So now part C, that is design of fogged end. Providing a phosphorus bronze bush of 3 mm thickness, and thickness of each eye of the fogged end is equal to L2 by 2, which is 12.5 mm over here. Now inner diameter of eye is D2 plus 2 into 3, so it is equal to 20 plus 6, so 26 mm, and outer diameter of eye is 2 times the inner diameter of eye. So we can even take as 52 mm, or we can take 2 times diameter of pin. So it will be equal to 40 mm. So this is about the design of fogged end. Now, last step is design of lever. Lever will be subjected to bending failure at section YY as we have discussed in the previous slides. So, bending moment equation is equal to W into L1 minus radius of boss at fulcrum. After substituting values, we get bending moment as 2.088 into 10 raised to 6 Newton mm. Section modulus for a YY section is TB square by 6. Here we are not given relation between B and T. So let us assume B is equal to 3T. So Z comes 1 upon 6T into 3T the whole square. So it is 9 by 6 T cube. Now we will use a bending stress equation. Sigma B is equal to M upon Z. So let us substitute values of M, Z, and sigma B. The only unknown in this equation is T. So we will get here T, which is 26.476 mm, say 28 mm, and B is equal to 28 into 3. So it comes 84 mm. And design of ball crank lever is over. So students, I hope you have enjoyed the numerical of